hit him. Woo! It works! Whoa! Oh, that's powerful. Hey everybody, how's life treating you? I'm Russ Robo, and welcome back to Skyrim Modded. Ultra-modded survival sort of thing. Yeah, Skyrim Ultra-modded survival. I've been doing a lot of grinding in the last episode since I left off. We were right outside the cave that was right behind the area with the necromancer that I wanted to take out so that I could summon the bone army. I've done a lot of stuff since then. I wish I kind of hadn't done it all off camera, but I'll try to keep doing that to a minimum. I'll try to keep that to a minimum. I have a lot of explaining to do. Okay, for first off, I left that area. I went to Solitude, sold a bunch of things, did a lot of alchemy, leveled up again. Then I took the cart from Solitude to Riften and did the Grimsever, retrieved the Grimsever quest, the ultimate awesome sword quest, to get Miol the Lioness as a follower. During that quest, there was actually a lot of Falmer in that area, and a lot of armor in that area that you could find. I found all of that armor, and I gave it and Grim Sever to... Pardon me. I gave the armor and Grim Sever to Miol the Lioness. So she's been following us around since Riften. And then I went from Riften, took the cart back to... back to Solitude, and then walk back from Solitude to the Draugr Tomb where I last left you off. Now, I have some good news and I have some bad news. The good news is, okay. I think that Inigo actually shot an arrow and already killed the necromancer that we were looking for. Unfortunately, after that, I heard a roar, and I think that means a dragon has shown up. I saw his shadow, I paused the game, and here we are. I'm going to resume in just a second. Okay, here we go. And obviously, I've got the camera working again. I don't necessarily like the angle of it, but hey, beggars can't be choosers, right? Okay, let's go and do this. No pressure. We got this. I'm not gonna die. I'm absolutely not gonna die.
I love the cold there. It's exhilarating.
Oh, I also got the little pet mud crab.
But there's something about it that makes me feel alive.
Oh boy. Let's change the system thing up a bit. Settings. Audio. I'm down with music, a little bit of music. I'll probably use my own, though. Dwarven bow! No, I need to use spells. Firebolt! I don't know whether it's a fire-type dragon or an ice-type dragon, though. Let's just get his attention. Throw a couple at him. Even if I just go near him. What? Is he gonna attack or not? Come on down there, champ. Let's go! I could manage to hit him. Oh, that's miles off. No, he's just teasing me. Oh, lame. Whatever. Well, anyway, we have our little... our dwarven armored mud crab that I paid for. He was a pretty penny. And, of course, we have Inigo. And then, of course, we have Lydia. Or, Miol. Miol. I'm so used to... Everyone has Lydia as a follower. She's kind of a standard. And I like her armor. It's pretty cool. That's the one that she used to have all the time when I used to play on PlayStation. Hey, get over here. I want, yes, butterfly wings. Man, it's been a long time since I played. I'm not used to the controls anymore. I mean, I am, but I'm not.
My fleas seem to enjoy this moist environment.
Oh, God, we don't need to know about your fleas there. What? Why can't I grab you? Grab. Got it. I don't have much time. I can't be getting distracted by butterflies. Squirrel! Okay. Anyway, we're back on the quest for the necromancer thingy. Wait, where are we? Oh, I have to highlight miscellaneous quest, don't I? No, that wasn't a miscellaneous quest. I could have sworn I highlighted it. it. There we go. Defeat the necromancer. Search the necromancer. See, I think Inigo got him already. And you know what? I've been playing for Skyrim for years, and I learned something recently. You know, you learn something new every day. I've been ignoring the corundum ore. I did not know that iron and corundum make steel. I've been that stupid all along. I did not know. I thought it had something to do with dwarven ingots, making dwarven ingots, and I always knew that it was super heavy, so I just ignored it. And of course, I'm recording, so my nose itches automatically. That's just a thing. Now I don't know. There might
my
be enemies still in this area.
My mother told me never to trust anyone who carries around more than 2 ears. Do you really need so many?
I have Falmer ears from fighting Falmer. Severely thirsty. Oh yeah, I forgot. I gotta eat and drink. What am I under? I'm cold, moderate fatigue, moderate hunger, and severe thirst. We gotta fix that. Let's get some food in us. Ooh, apple cabbage stew. And maybe a little bit of bread? Like some breadsticks with that? There we go, well sated. Now we need water. We've got plenty of water skins. Oh, usually takes about 2 of those. Excellent, excellent, excellent. I made some soup while I was in the city too. What was that? I heard a thing. Everybody sneak, everybody stay down. Oh, it's this bone dog, isn't it? Huh. Well, I ain't letting him out. It's time to search this necromancer. He had a nice little setup over here, didn't he? I'll take that pelt. Why the heck not? Totem bone. Oh, I see. So he wasn't like, he wasn't a very powerful enemy, so I don't think he really missed much. Necromancer's journal, right arm. Oh, I've been collecting the bone pieces as well. Let's read the journal. This is truly remarkable. Through my experiments with these undead wolves, I have discovered a method to increase my power. By consuming their totems, objects that bind them between life and death itself, I combine their spirits to my own life force. I have already consumed 2 totems, and their hosts are now completely under my control. But this is not enough. I need a 3rd totem to be sure. Interesting. I don't know if I should have to take that. Totem bone? Yeah, I guess I do. That must start the quest. Or continue it on. Take the totem to the caged wolf. Oh. Cooking spit. I can cook! Oh man, I forgot I'm wearing dwarven now. That really threw me off. Porker stew. I can make more stew.
I've never been a sellsword.
Sheltered.
Never faded my skills for pay.
Restores 15 points of stamina, restores 15 points of health, restores 1 point of health per second for 720 seconds. Yes! I got close enough to the ocean, too, to make salt water. Not sponsored. Said I could make salt. I love all the soups. The soups are the best things that you can make for your health. Well, for your food, you know. Decreasing your hunger. Nice. Oh, he was actually going to do more cooking animations. I'll have to check those out later. Yeah. It's so hard to aim the control stick with this thing. Okay. But I didn't... I'm glitchy about these controls. They don't work the same. I want it to operate exactly like the old PS3 edition. Purloin shadows. Huh. What is that one? Candle was lit and the thief was... I better read that later. Werewolf pelt. That's new. Sleep on hay bale. No thank you. Let's go do the thing. I'm not sure what to do about the dwarven mud crab. He does find stuff every now and again. I think that's his main purpose. He picked me up like 8 gold earlier. But it's very rare and totally random. Oh, I need the key. God dang it. Am I still in sneak? I'm so slow. We gotta get this key off the necromancer. I thought I was just gonna break into it. Key to wolf gauge. Excellent, excellent. Okay, everybody. Let's find out what this do. There's also like, okay. Complete it. Take the totem to the caged wolf. Totem bone removed. Come with me. I need you to carry something or wait for me in the city. Let sleeping wolves lie. Oh my god, I have a bone wolf pet. That's right, I bought the teleport pet. Bone wolf added. Bone wolf's revenge added. Oh, spells, I assume. Jesus Christ, we're a whole army now. This is great. This is exactly what I wanted. A veritable entourage. Of course, the mud crab does not fight. Mud crab, he no fight. Now, we need to do the other necromancy thing. Map. Like, now we're actually leveling up to the point where I can do this stuff. I don't know why I did that. I need, quests. Taste of Death. Forbidden Legend. Lydia's Beacon. Speak with no. Inigo. Invasive. There it is. The Rising Dead. I've received an anonymous letter asking me to help stop a group of necromancers who are planning to raise an army of zombies. I should investigate the ritual site. If I remember correctly, it's like halfway across the friggin' map. I might take the carriage. Where is it at? It should be right outside of Windhelm. Whoa, where'd it go? What the blue blazes? Oh, it's above Helgen? Yeah, just above Helgen. So here's what I want to do. We want to go back to Solitude, take the cart to Whiterun, and run from Whiterun to Helgen. Yes. Okay, well, I will pause the camera, and we will be back shortly after that. Alrighty, everybody, we're back. We're just outside of Helgen. From my perspective, that took about an hour. From your perspective, pretty much nothing, you know? I took the cart from Solitude to Whiterun, did a whole bunch of selling, some more enchanting, and then, what do you call it, went from Whiterun to Helgen here.
I really miss traveling like this. Walking the breadth of Skyrim has always
filled my heart with excitement.
Excuse me, my friend.
Okay, I like listening to them every now and again. It's pretty cool. Okay, so I guess I'll just pick some things along the way. I made sure to reduce my weight, too, while I was in town. I'm not going to focus on alchemy stuff right now. I mainly want to get to our objective. It's going to be a cult of necromancers, though, so maybe I should be ready for anything. I'm not sure. All I know is it's freaking hot in this room. No sneaky. Takes too long. Let's run up there. Good god, my stamina degenerates fast. Severely fatigued. Yeah, I forgot about that. I did not sleep at an inn before all this happened, so I'm under a lot of effects right now. I'm gonna have to be very careful. As a matter of fact, let me check. Oh no. Magic and stamina are down, way down. Oh god. I do not want to have to get sleep during all this. No. Maybe there's some bed I can sleep in that fort there. We're gonna have to... Newgrod. We're gonna have to fight our way in there, aren't we? Friendly fort, maybe? Friendly fort? No. No, not friendly. No, definitely not friendly. I have a new spell I can use, though. I have a new spell. It's a scroll. I've been waiting to use this. Let's check it out. Scroll of the Twister. Creates a tornado at the target location. A direct hit sucks up a target, dealing 36 frost damage for 10 seconds. Nearby targets take half damage. Only works outdoors. Let's use it. Wait, no, wrong one.
Damn it.
No, that's the thing. Oh god, no. Okay. Bandits. What? Why won't it attack? Why won't it do the thing? Oh, there it goes. Everybody stay out of that thing. Oh god, no. I messed it all up. Inigo, no, everybody stay out of it. Okay, apparently it's done. This is so much easier to play off camera. It's the weirdest thing about this. Dwarven bow. We're looking for any enemies left over. I need to take them out so I can use one of their bedrolls to sleep in. Where'd Inigo go? Well, we got a bad one right here. I'm gonna try to get a headshot if I can. It's so difficult to move this reticle. Bingo! What? You can't tell me that didn't hit. Huh. Maybe they're already dead. Nope. I got them. Might want to back up now. Okay, Mio was in the way. I couldn't get around it. Whoa, what's with the lightning? Oh god, they've got a necromancer! They knocked me out. Oh god, I have no defense against magic at all. What happened? Man, that's tough. Okay, well. God, now I'm way back here.
I'm bored. Let's play a game.
I don't even know who's got what. What's the most recent thing I did?
I've got a dagger if you're interested, traveler.
I'm itching for a fight.
No problem. I can carry a good bit of gear. All set. Let's go.
Oh boy. Okay, here we are. Back again for the last bloody time. It's very loud at this end. I made sure to sleep, eat, and drink. So I'm well sated. I'm fed. I'm watered. I've slept. I'm not gonna die in one hit this time. I think. I might need to put some, oh, and it's nice. It's good during the daytime, so I guess we'll be starting our adventure from here. That's the quickest way. Let's go this way. It's more original. I'm just gonna run all the way there. And this time I think we'll do better, and we won't have to go into that fort. We won't have to endanger ourselves, but I do have to go through Helgen at some point. And I didn't want to record from here, but I guess this is just the way I'm gonna have to start it, you know. Just getting there is part of the journey. Maybe it's about the journey instead of the destination. Of all of the recordings I have, any video I've ever made, Skyrim is the hardest. Skyrim is the most difficult. Skyrim has taken the most effort for me to actually get the camera set up right, the game set up right, the recording set up right, so if the game crashes I don't lose my data. It's a nightmare. It's a nightmare. And honestly, a lot of people play Skyrim without followers. I'm so much better at this game without the camera recording on, because whenever the recording on is on, I feel like I'm in a rush. Oh. What is that noise? It's probably just the dog. Whenever the recording isn't on, I stop, I play slow, I pick up all the plants. I mean, you can see the level I am. I've done a lot of easy grinding off camera. The game's, like, super easy, you know, if you just slow down, breathe, and take it easy. But if you try to rush it, you'll wind up just getting taken out constantly. Plus, I have a lot of things in my way. I've got a frickin' mic down here, and there's the recording set up in the way. It's difficult. We'll get past it. We'll get past it. I'll get past it. Oh no. Well, does that even go through? Does that mine go through the area? Because if it does, I want to use it. Oh god, so I need to go over here. Ooh, I should try that tornado spell again. Hold up. Because now I should still have the scroll since I died. Scroll. Scroll of Twister. Okay, it's going to confuse me, so I want to unequip the other hand. Okay. Now it's just this. I want to hit him. Woo! It works! Whoa! Oh, that's powerful. I told you this would be worth it. Maybe I should keep doing the series. That was awesome. I will take all of your goods. No, the coin purse, thank you. Is this barrel empty as well? I don't need sacks of flour. If it was like some cream stew or something. I can use the cooking pot. I don't know if there's anything I can cook, though. I think I've cooked all the food that I can cook for now. Oh, no. You can get me a horker loaf. I've got some salt piles on me. Make sure to get these legs of goat roasts out of the way, and I don't want any raw pheasant breasts on us. Oh, man, and that was a bandit outlaw, so at my level, they're actually, you know, halfway decent. I'll take that mead. That was awesome. Oh, no, was it just him by himself? I thought there were, like, three or four enemies over here. Dang it. Well, it looked cool, but I wasted it. Reed Warrior. Block increased to 17. That's good, that's good. Chest. Ooh, garnet. Gold and greater soul gem. I've got actually a trick for getting a lot of souls and soul gems. Basically, you just give your follower your all of your unfilled soul gems and then enchant one of their weapons, either a sword or a bow, with soul trap. That way you don't have to worry about, I didn't remember to cast soul trap on this enemy before we fought. Now he's knocked out and he's not in the soul gem. And I say knocked out instead of the other word because YouTube. Can't say D-I-E. Can't say it. I like knocked out. Captain Sparkle says unlive. We're going to unlive this skeleton. I don't know about unlive. I like knocked out. Just say knocked out instead of the K word. Or the D word. Well, basically, to be clear, I guess since this video, I don't think it'll ever be monetized. It's kill and die. You can't say kill or die. You know, you're not going to kill your enemies, and they're not going to die. You know, because that's too morbid. You got to be like, I'm going to knock them out. Nobody's going to watch this. Who am I kidding? What's with the dog? Uh-oh. Enemies? Oh no, I got the steel mace of shock blasts. Interesting. I'm probably going the complete wrong way. Looks like there's another trail up here, leads towards our destination.
No sign of
them. What? Enemies? Okay, no enemies? Okay, we're good. And again,
say Skyrim is we've one got of like our dangerous places in Pamela.
That hunter was killing it. Oh, he's hunting animals. He killed a foxy. Oh.
And I'm proud to call it home.
Dang. Oh well. I guess I should have picked up his pelt and put it to good use, but I don't know, man. Well, at least we're closer to our destination now, and this time I've had some food. It's a shame I don't have that scroll anymore, though. And also, if you're wondering why I'm missing all of these alchemical ingredients, I'm going to do more of that stuff off camera. Like, that's the kind of stuff I'll do on my own time when I'm walking from city to city. Doing it during a recording is just a wee bit too tedious. I know we're about the destination here, but more so than that, we're more about the journey here, but more so than that, I actually do want to make it to the destination, because the main thing I wanted to do with this channel was, the main thing I wanted to do with this series was show fights, man. I remember back, even on the PS3 edition, I used to have some awesome battles, because I would summon a dragon, because you can do that with a shout later on in the game. And then an actual dragon will be attacking us. So it'll be two dragons fighting, and then trolls on the ground coming at me while the two dragons are fighting, and possibly necromancers and vampires, and like the way it used to be, there were always like five or more enemies. I need to pay more attention to this walk. I don't have a lot of picks left. Oh, is it just standard up and down? That was just default. That was just standard up and down. Oh, right, I forgot. This whole area is crawling with enemies. Let's decrease their stamina. Ooh, I got him with one. Oh, okay, they're just regular bandits, so we're fine. These two, look at them. Hey, that's a good screenshot. Shot. Good screenshot. Not good screenshot. Oh! Wham! Oh, Inigo, I'm sorry. You stepped right in the way, buddy. Oh, Christ. Whoa, Kaiji Battle Axe Berserker's Wraith. It's a little heavy, though. I'm going to give it to Inigo and see if he'll use it. Wow. Ooh, water skins. I could always use those. Another bandit. Iron Dagger, Hip Bones, Scepter. See, it's called Kaijit's Wraith, and I've seen that before, and I had the option to use it myself or make it myself. But he's kind of like, Inigo is more of a dual wielding sort of ally. Oh, there's still enemies around here. I want him using two cutlasses, or two. How do they pronounce? Falchion? The curvy swords. There's tons of them. Where the heck are these guys? They're probably in those buildings somewhere. I don't know. If I can get past them, maybe I should. Orcish Great Sword of Slow Burning. Ooh. Added. Can I go over this rubble, or is it closed off? Huh. I'm gonna leave him alone. We got places to be. Things to do. Besides, they're probably just more standard bandits anyway. Oh boy, got it. Hey, you know what? Let's see if Inigo can do it. He's got lockpicks. I wonder what... I mean, his skill in lockpicking is probably pretty good.
Speak to me.
I need you to do something for me.
What would you have me do? I will aid you if I can.
Yes. Do it.
Good idea.
Hey, he likes that idea. Is he? Yeah, there we go. Oh, he's gonna walk up to it. You could have been a bit more quick with that. Is he doing it?
What do you say? I am with you, my friend.
Okay, he did it. Saved me a couple lockpicks. I like it. I like it a lot. This is where we were the last time. Oh, man. Okay, well, this time, I'm not so fatigued. Not quite so fatigued. So that shall help. Whew. And I've got the vents open, so it won't be so hot in here. I should try to roleplay more. I should try to talk to Lydia. Or, dang it, not Lydia. Miol. I should try to talk to Miol and Inigo. You know, get used to having them in my party. I don't know if I should give this guy a name. Carry something for me in the city. Stay here. Aww. He's such a creepy looking dog, though. And a lot of people... Pete is going to hate this episode. Oh, people are not going to watch the series anymore because it's like cruelty to animals. Oh, God. This makes no sense. I'm going to find like a nice Draugr tomb or like some sort of deep, dark, dank cave. But I don't want to leave them all alone. Oh, God. want to find some place where he can be happy and alone and free. Or not alone. I don't know. Oh lord, it's chilly now. I almost want revenge on that spellcaster that killed me, but I'm gonna let it slide. We've got things we need to do. Fort Newgrad. Oh yeah, well, Fort Newgrad sucks. I don't know if you could, I mean, I know you can craft, this is unrelated by the way, this is in relation to the bone dog. In smithing, I know that you can actually craft a collar, like an animal collar. I thought about giving one to Inigo, but I felt like that was incredibly, incredibly racist. Because, you know, give a Khajiit an animal collar, like he's some sort of pet cat. Oh, God. I'm going to have to rate this series R or have it age restricted or something. I don't know. But I didn't know if giving a pet a collar would allow you to name that pet, which is what I'd kind of like to do if I'm going to keep, you know, aka Bone Dog. I've never seen this area. All in my over 1,000 hours of playtime on this game. This is very nice. It's like a small lake. A little boat here. Does it lead out? Is there... oh, can I zoom in? There we go. The lake appears to lead out... No, it's an isolated lake, not a river system. That's impressive. If only there was a mod that would allow me to get in this boat and boat around a little bit. Huh. I bet there is a mod that allows that. You ever notice that's kind of weird how in Minecraft they have... I mean, it's a little dinghy of a boat, but it's still a boat. And Skyrim, the great and powerful Skyrim, never had the ability to actually get on a boat and go in the water. I mean, not that a lot of people want to do that. I want to look for a game like that. What is it? That's a bear trap. There, I saved an animal today. I maybe saved an animal, possibly. We need to be looking for a way in. Hold up, we got something here. Steps maybe? Hold up, I think there's something there. No. We are stuck by sheer cliff, and I've only got 12 minutes of recording time left. I will get past this mountain. Okay, I don't want to cheese it. I'll wind up getting stuck and crashing the game. God, am I really going to have to go all the way around? What's going on here, champ? Okay, I think I got something here. Not that way, maybe this way. People will know the struggle. Do I edit all of this out? Or do I just leave it in to show the struggle? Hold up, we got some. Hello, what are you? Looks like Ori Calcum. I'll take it. Honestly, this episode has gone on so long, I'm kinda wishing this was a beer. I should have paid attention to what I got. I didn't look at it at all. I should have paid attention, because sometimes you can get gems. Oh, I just gave all my gems recently to Inigo, so if I have any new gems... Garnet? I might have gotten that from that. No, I think the garnet... No, the garnet came from one of the bandits we killed. Oh no, knocked out! Whoopsie! hey, is that a... That's a dragon tomb. A dragon burial site, right? I don't see old what's-his-face come to resurrect his good buddy, huh? Whee, Spinny! Okay. Good old what's-his-face, frickin'... Good God, have I actually forgotten the main enemy of this game? Has it been that long? Okay, hang on. No, I know this. Oh, what was that? Oh, it's really cold in this area. Dang it, what's his freaking name? I can't remember his name. Oh, I think I saw something. Is that more ore? No, I thought it was more ore. Well, I do not remember his name at all. Man, I can't believe that. I cannot get into this area. Oh, we got something here. This is definitely a thing. Yes. Because those stone sigils are only... See, and I couldn't actually even get here if it hadn't been for the fact that I did some tweaking with the mod, so it won't knock you out. Hold up. Ooh. Let's go with a summon. Conjuration. Cat totem. No, Deadeye cat. Oh. Whoa. Need some healing. Go get him, boy! Whoa, he's tough. Okay, back off.
Yeah, like a dunmer.
Enough. Spell sword, eh? I spike. No, if he is using magic, then we need to go with lightning. Hey, get your butt over. What the? Oh, they dropped him. Whoa! Why am I falling? Oh snap! I didn't even see that. I almost fell to my death. How far down am I? Can I get back up there? Sweet Jiminy Christmas. Must traverse landscape. Cannot blast it. How do you fall down like that? I can't get all this stuff out of my way. Let's go with healing. Whoa, what the? Did I step on a bear trap? I think I stepped on a bear trap. No! Enemy? There's Neol. She must have dropped whatever was attacking me. There's, Inigo. Oh, yeah. South Ridge Sanctum. Interesting. There's some alchemy. Alchemy stand. I'm gonna check that apothecary satchel. Juniper berries. Whoop, harvest the nightshade, but don't go into the sanctum. We have somewhere else we're supposed to be. Now that I'm back up here, I can check that sellsword's inventory. See what all he had on him. Where the heck did he go? See, that's one thing that bothers me about them is, I don't know if I should have, followers, especially two followers, this early on in the game. Because, they just seem to drop everything so easily. Especially with their bow and arrows. I took all of those ebony arrows out of Inigo's inventory. They're just too broken. He starts out with an ebony bow and ebony arrows. It's a one-shot kill on almost everything he's fought. I don't even get to fight. That's why I'm so weak. Oh, hey, it's the zombies that we're supposed to be doing the thing with. Okay. They already know I'm here, so there ain't no point in hiding. Got you. Whoa. Oh, Inigo's dropping them and capturing their souls. Boom, got them. They're coming at us in waves. I'm gonna have to go with a single shot. Oh, snap. There's a lot of them. Okay. Healing. Ooh. That's what their strength is. They attack in numbers. Okay. I'm gonna take the Welket Stone, because I never get to use it. It's gonna completely restore magicka. And then we're gonna come over here and go conjuration and summon the cat totem. And then oak flesh to make me stronger. And then switch to healing. Beautiful. We did it. We took them down. Wow, they were literally a whole, like, group of them. See, that's I've been looking for that.
I've never been a sense.
I've been looking for that kind of action. Let's go and sneak and see what they got on them. Orcish sword. Mort flesh. Ooh. I always eat the first thing. Wait a minute, mort flesh. That's from Oblivion. They haven't had that since Oblivion. Oh, man. I remember those days. Those were good times. Good times. Unfortunately, I always eat whatever I find in terms of alchemy to figure out the first ingredients, so I'm gonna eat it. Damage health. Why wasn't I able to immediately just, like, why didn't I know that would do that? No, they got some good stuff. Okay, take. They got good weapons. I guess it's whatever weapon they were wielding at the time. There's a whole group of them. Came at us all at once. Imagine if I hadn't had my followers, I'd have been swarmed. And, Inigo captured a lot of, souls. Like, really did. So this is part of our quest. I downloaded this DLC so that it would turn it into, not necessarily 7 days to die at all. Ooh, paladin sword. Holy crud, that looks cool. Okay, we gotta have that. Crap. I'll give something to Inigo. I downloaded this mod so that it would sort of, zombies are supposed to attack in waves at night. Just like that. Make nighttime more dangerous. Inigo, I need you to carry the sword.
What do you need?
I get so heavy.
I will lighten your load if I can.
Oh, that's right. My item has been giving me enchanted weapons. So I'm just going to have him hold all of my weapons and he can use whatever he wants. Except for, you know, whatever I'm using. Ooh, that's right. I forgot I picked up that. I'll give that to Mjoll. Orcish Great Sword of Slow Burning. Oh, I'll give that to Mjoll too. What does it do? Burns target burns for 2 points per second until combat ends. Oh, wow, it's permanent. Paladin Sword. Don't need that. Oh, I gotta sell that. Shock Blast. Electrifies the ground underneath the target, dealing 6 points of damage for 10 seconds. Anything magical, I ought to just give them so that they can use all of the charges on it. And then as soon as they're done with the charges, I can sell the magical item. Because as it turns out, they didn't fix that, where when you sell a magical item, it doesn't matter how many charges it has left on it. It sells for the exact same amount, which I thought was kind of glitchy, but hey, it's whatever. I'm going to give you some more weapons. She looks weird squat like that. It looks totally weird. I don't know what she's going to choose to use. She might choose to use any of the weapons I give her, actually. Who knows? You get this, and this, and I guess, would she... No, I've got enough weight. I don't need to give
all
her that,
set.
Too.
Let's go.
Okay, so she's not picking anything else above Grimsever. I've got about a minute left. Oh my god, no! Dang it, camera, hang in there. Search zombie. More mort flesh. Apprentice necromancer. Conjure zombie. Probably don't need that. So we need to find out what's going on here. Mort flesh. Eye of Saber Cat, Hagraven Feathers. There it is. There it is. There's something going on here. What is this? Search. Lunar Mothwing. What is this book? I need to know what this book is. What's the book? Why is my quest marker pointing? Where's my quest marker pointing? Honeycomb. Okay. I'm supposed to investigate what's going on, right? I'm running out of time. Huh. Oh crap, did the book fall through the ground? What on God's green earth do I do if the book fell through the ground? What is this one? Is this Conjure Zombie? No! Oh god, no, the book fell through the ground. What do I do? What am I... Hang on, search. No, that's definitely not it. There's something in there. And I'm supposed to get it. And is it in the ground? Maybe it got knocked downhill? Hold on, what does the quest specifically say? Investigate the ritual site. Great. Maybe it's in here. And we're back, folks. I have no idea what in the name of good gravy I'm supposed to do with this ritual site.
But that's what it was all about.
Search zombie. Should I raise a zombie in the area? What's this? No, that's my Minecraft. Empty necromancer. Dang it, battery. I've got an idea. Hang on. They want me to do Ray Zombie, right? Where's the Ray Zombie book? I probably already know it. Oh my goodness. Alright, spell to encounter zombie. Okay. Summons a zombie for 73 seconds wherever the caster is pointing. So I know it now. And in order to make sure that it works perfectly, I probably do want to use it exactly as it conjure zombie. Okay. There's conjure zombie, raise zombie, reanimate corpse. Reanimate corpse is more powerful than the other two, but I'll go with conjure zombie just because I want to do it exactly as the quest specifies. Maybe it'll do something. Interesting. So now I don't need a body in order to conjure. I just do. Frick. There's gotta be something I'm missing. Maybe I can foos Rodai it out of the ground. Shouts? Probably won't be powerful enough. No? Where exactly? Map. Am I? Investigate the ritual site. This is the ritual site. Very odd. Maybe I was supposed to come here at a certain time of day. I just wish it would give me quest completed. I imagine there was some sort of book that fell through the ground. That's all I can think. I read all the books in the area. Whatever it is pointing me way down there. Maybe it is way down there. There's nothing down there except the side of a mountain. Huh.
I've never been a sellsport. Never traded my skills for pay. I've always adventured on my own.
Huh. Maybe if I try the Ray Zombie thing on the Necromancers. Conjuration, raise. No, it's conjure. No, it's conjure zombie. Yeah, yeah. Try Gotta summon him right on top of the thing. Blast it. Huh. Yeah, it's beneath us somehow. Huh. Very odd. Okay, I don't have my camera anymore, but there's so many things I need to say. You know that area where I was at the investigating the ritual site, and how it seemed like the map marker for the investigation of the ritual site was down beneath me? I think it might have been in the cave that was actually behind the ritual site. Now, I came in here, right, and I started fighting cell swords, and I fought this guy named Bashnag. He was a pretty good mage, pretty strong. They had this necromancer tied up in webs, it seems, and I think she's got something to do with this quest, but I don't know if it's a miscellaneous quest or if it actually has to do with the necromancy coven, but we're gonna continue from here and find out what's going on.
I left for a few days in Riften. When I came back, Bashnag accused me of trying to sell him out to the Thalmor. I was cursed and chased off. My daughter was sent to the orphanage there when I stood accused of illegal necromancy. I had no choice, run or die. I joined with Bashnag then, but I thought of Savella every day, so I snuck off hoping to find and steal away with her. Only she was gone, shipped away to another orphanage or adopted, or... I didn't know what else to do, so I came back hoping nobody noticed I left. I'm too weak right now. Between the spiders and the coven, I'd be dead before escaping the cave.
Tell me more about the coven.
These are no dainty college mages. Bashnag has the skill of a magister and the mind of a warlord. This is a dangerous bunch. They're good company. If you want to study necromancy in peace, though.
Bash, you're a necromancer?
I am, and I don't want to hear your moral judgments about it either. I wouldn't have had to study in secret in the old days.
How are you holding up?
I'm feeling better. But Bashnag's curse won't wear off for weeks.
I'm gonna tell her Bashnag is dead.
They're good company.
Bashnag is dead.
He is. I'm not sure how to feel about that. Perhaps it's for the better.
I'm gonna ask her if she can make it out of here. Can you make it out of here?
Between the spiders and Bashnag cursed me. I can't cast a spell to save my life right now. I'll have to wait until the way out is safe. Please,
the way isn't safe. Wait here. Okay. We're gonna switch to that quest. Find out what's going on with all this. This must be a miscellaneous. Help Selvini Nethiri escape the cave. Okay, so she's right here. We'll keep an eye on her. I want to make sure that the way out is clear. Oh, spiders. Definitely not clear. I'm going to go with... I don't know. Something, I want something AoE, somebody that can really get in there and deal some damage. How about this guy? They can't kill Dramora Charl. That guy. He'll take all three of them down. Nice. The only downside to him is that if something kills him, he is resummoned under the control of what it was that last killed him. Holy crud, that's huge! That's the biggest frostbite spider I've ever seen! I gotta get in there. Whoa, crap, this is bad. He was just killed. Toph sword. Oh, it's done. But where's the chorl? Oh, he got it. Oh, there was one down on the ground. Oh man, I didn't even see that. That was so cool. Are we safe? It's the biggest frostbite spider I've ever seen. Holy crud. This thing is huge. That is awesome. Okay. We're gonna take all this frostbite venom. Oh my gosh, my camera's dead unfortunately, so I can't continue using it for right now. But this'll be the last part of the episode, I think, as soon as I can get her out of this blasted cave. Now I made sure the way behind us was clear, the way we came in, but I think she wants to come out this way. And it's probably better if both ways are clear. Careful, in you go. There could be anything dangerous up ahead. Hop, 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 hop. Oh, he's ready. He is ready. My boy is ready right now. You see how ready he is? He is ready. Look at how ready he is. I can't make this fucking game serious even when I try. I'm trying to be cinematic, you know? I'm trying to make this a little bit more serious. Jesus fucking Christ. Okay. Okay. Ooh, spoopy. And you know what? I haven't seen it activate yet, but this sword is supposed to have an ability that if my enemy is low on stamina, when I hit them, it conjures up an earth spike underneath them and deals a butt ton of damage. At least that's what the enchantment says, but I haven't seen it work yet. Oh my god, how did I miss this? We're right back where we started. Wow! Okay, it's time to tell her the way is clear then. I guess I could have gone through this way and then out the other way. Oh wow. But I guess she really doesn't have anything to do with the necromancy quest. Well, if she doesn't, then that's awful. Maybe she doesn't, but this was still fun. Not to mention the fact that, like, I wonder... She's got to have something to do with something. I made sure the way is clear, so I'm glad that she'll be safe.
I'm feeling better. But Bashnag's curse won't wear off for weeks.
Can you make it out of here?
Cursed me.
The way is... Well, I can't cast the way out is clear. Good luck.
Thank you. When I find my daughter, it will be thanks to you.
Okay. So she gonna go, she's gonna leave the cave? Anygo, we gotta get out of her way, I guess. I don't know. I'll keep my map marker on her. Is she gonna follow us? No, she's going on her own, isn't she? Or is she following us? No, she's definitely following us. Okay, so we're gonna exit the cave now. With her in tow, I imagine. Keep an eye on her. Come on now.
This place smells troublesome.
There we go.
Maybe a good idea to
there we go. Good. Use that good auto tracking. Use that good tracking. Come on, this way. There you go. What am I stuck on? Okay, this way. I'm trying to friggin' walk backwards here. Come on. Come on up. Blasted. Huh. Her AI is not too great. Well, she really is stuck. Look at her walking in slow-mo. Come on now.
When I find my daughter, it will be thanks to you.
Well, lady, you ain't never gonna find anything if you stay there walking in slow-mo. There we go. God, now I'm stuck. There are too many people in this cave. There are not enough room for all of us. What are you doing? What are you doing, lady? Maybe it would have been better for her to go out the other way. Come on. Is she coming? It's this way. Come on. Oh, boy. Okay, let's try this one more time.
When I find my daughter, it will be thanks to you.
Yes, yes. Okay, come on. You know what? We're gonna go the other way. Apparently she wants to go this way now. So she was following us before, but for some reason, clicking on her again made her auto-target to the other side of the cave. Oh, she's walking pretty quick. I'm actually falling behind. Should I run for a spell? Wait, where'd she go? She's not gonna do that thing where she's just automatically gone, is it? Don't do that. Don't be that way. Come on, let's keep up. Frick! Okay, this way. Yeah, she's running. She's booking it. Hold up, lady. You can't be booking it without me like that. Don't you do it. Oh. What are your stories? What are your secrets? What is the truth behind the necromancy in this area? How do I summon an army of skeletons? You get back here, you tell me what I want to know. Okay, waiting for my stamina to come back up. Come on. Wait a minute. I'm better than this. I've got stamina. Hold up. Restore. Yeah. Just, boop. 2, 3, 4. Okay, I don't want to drink too much. Because I was going to install that potion toxicity mod, where it forces you not to drink too many potions, because the more you drink, the less and less effective they become. Completed. We did it. She escaped. Good God, she's fast. So now what happens? We helped her escape, but what happens to the quest? Did I investigate the ritual site or what? Am I going to be able to find her again someday, somewhere, somehow? Where'd she go? Jiminy Christmas. She's over here, maybe? Where'd she go?
People say Skyrim.
Hold up. Magic. Clairvoyance. Alteration. I never use clairvoyance, but sometimes it's actually pretty helpful. There we go. Is she part of this? It seems like she's going right there. That is the quest that I had targeted. Wait a minute. Is it still doing that? No! No! Where is she at? Oh, I see. Since I helped her escape, it automatically undid it. Ah, blast it. The Rising Dead. So, that really didn't have anything to do with this quest. Yeah. It's still underneath the ground here. I imagine it was some sort of book. I've searched all the necromancers. I imagine it was some sort of book that just fell into the ground or something. Okay, so in the next episode, we shall be investigating the quest line Blue in the Face. We'll be doing it with me, all the Lioness, and Inigo. I don't know if Mr. Mudcrab and Mr. Bone Wolf are going to stay by our side, because they got stuck a while back on a rock inside the cave, and it was actually kind of nice to not have them following me around, because it was a lot quieter, much more peaceful. But anyway, I'll see you all in the next video. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. Hopefully the next one will be better. And let's see, I guess I'll see you in the next one, and take it easy, my friends.